Chaya and Utsav are very good friends. They study and play together. Chaya has a keen interest in science, and Utsav is always curious about learning new things. Once both of them were studying together in Chaya's room, but Utsav was not being able to concentrate much in studies that day. Suddenly, Utsav notices something on the mirror of the dressing table.
What are you looking at in the mirror, Utsav?
Chaya, I am thinking that how we are able to see our picture, I mean our image in the mirror, whereas we don't see it in a water glass.
Nice question. I know this much, that it is somewhat related to the light. Let's go to the courtyard and do some experiments over there. Utsav, can you feel that we can see more clearly outside the house?
I agree. The sunlight is much brighter than the light of the room's bulb.
Absolutely correct. We are able to see due to light. Light is necessary to see things. When the light reaches our eyes after getting reflected by some object, then only we are able to see that object.
Chaya, I did not get that. Light reaches to us after getting reflected back. But light rays go straight through the water and we are able to see inside it too. Also, we can see a little bit through water glass.
Wait a minute.
Chaya goes inside and brings back a glass full of water and 2 1-rupee coins.
Utsav, look attentively.
Chaya drops a coin in the glass filled with water and lifts the glass with one hand and the other coin in the other hand.
Utsav, which coin can you see more clearly? The one in the glass or the other one in my palm?
The one in your palm.
Chaya closes her fist.
And now?
How can it be seen now? You have closed your fist.
Now, can you see the glass of water?
What are you talking about? How can I see it when you have covered the glass by your hand?
Utsav, some things are transparent, while some are not transparent. The things through which light can pass completely are known as transparent. For example, water, clear glass, and many things made from plastics like water bottles. We can see through these things. We can see an object when light passes through it and reaches us after getting reflected back from it. Let's come to things through which light cannot pass, are known as opaque objects. Light either bounces into another direction after hitting the objects or goes back.
Chaya, I can understand a little bit now. Please explain it a bit further.
Alright, look at those trees. Can you see their shadow?
Shadow, that's you. But yes, I can see the shadow of the trees.
Yes, the meaning of my name is shadow. Shadow of an object. Utsav, if you see attentively, you can see that the shadow of the glass of water is so light and we are almost unable to see the shadow of water. Whereas, the shadow of a ball is so dark. Shadow is formed when an opaque object comes in between the path of light. Like you can't see shadows at the places where trees are coming in the path of the light, we can't see through such objects.
Chaya, there are some things that I still can't understand. Like normal glass is transparent. But then how we are able to see our image in a mirror glass?
Utsav, this question is a bit tough. How shall I explain it to you? Alright, let's take help from our science book.
Chaya brings back her science book and opens it to read.
Yes, I had forgotten this thing. Utsav, there are some objects other than transparent and opaque which are known as translucent objects. These are objects through which light can pass partially, like butter paper and frosted glass, etc.
Okay, understood. But I still did not get the answer to my question.
I am telling you, have some patience and stand in front of the mirror. Now look first. The light from the bulb hits you, then reflects back to the mirror, and then gets reflected back once again on hitting the polished surface behind the mirror, and finally reaches our eyes, and hence we can see ourselves. In the very similar way, we are able to see the image of every object placed in front of the mirror. When light bounces back after hitting the objects, then this process is known as reflection of light. For understanding this, it was necessary for us to know about transparency and opaqueness of objects. Every object reflects light in different magnitudes. Transparent objects reflect the least amount of light, and opaque shiny objects reflect the most amount of the light. Translucent objects fall in between these two. These objects reflect almost all the light falling on it, so that we could see our image in it.
Okay, got it. It means that the light passes through the glass but reflects from the shiny smooth surface behind it.
Look, the back of the mirror is being polished by a shiny substance, which reflects all the light falling upon it.
Chaya, I have understood. Probably, this is the reason that we are able to see our image in the lot of shiny objects like shiny spoons and bowls.
Of course, shiny substances reflect more light.
Now one more question has crossed my mind.
I have told you everything I knew.
Yes, but I wanted to know that why do we see a smaller image of ours in a spoon?
Utsav, even I don't know the answer to this question. But this is a nice question. Both of us will discuss this with our teacher. Till then, let's find out the answer of your questions in our book itself.